The historic election, the world's biggest in the time of coronavirus. Bihar elections have been announced. Bihar will vote on October 28th, on November 3rd and 7th for the new assembly that will be voting now, and the results will be announced on November 10th. The world's biggest election in the coronavirus crisis will be held with many changes, including an extra voting hour and no physical contact during the campaign. Bihar has to elect 243 members in its assembly by 29th of November. Now, voting will take place from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. instead of 5 p.m. Remember, COVID patients, suspects and those in quarantine will vote separately, and there will be no physical contact during meetings and rallies as well. That's what the Chief Election Commissioner has said. Voters will have to also wear masks, gloves, and the number of phases have been reduced as well from 5 to minimum of 3 at this point. Now, COVID-19 patients can also vote, even suspects can vote, and that will happen the last hour of the day. This is what the Election Commissioner said.
First phase, issue of notification, 1st October. Last date of notification, 8th October. Scrutiny of nominations, 9th October. Is it clear? Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 12th October. Date of poll, 28th October. Counting of votes, 10th November, but that will be for all the phases, right? Can I now go to second phase, please? Issue of notification, 9th October. Last date of nomination, 16th October. Scrutiny of nomination, 17th October. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 19th October. Date of poll, 3rd November. Counting, as I said earlier, 10th November. Then I go to third phase. Issue of notification, 13th October. 13th October. Tera October. Last date of nomination, 20th October, 20th October. Scrutiny of nomination, 21st October, 21st October. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 23rd October, 23rd October. Date of poll, 7th November, 7th November. Counting of votes, 10th November. One of the first major steps which was taken was to reduce the maximum number of electors at the polling station from 1,500 to 1,000. I am sure you will kindly appreciate the magnitude of this revision, because the number of polling stations as a result of this decision went up from 65,337 in the year 2015, the year of last, and to more than 1 lakh in 2020. Special protocol has been devised for electors who are COVID positive, suspect, quarantine, so that such citizens are able to exercise their franchise without in any way jeopardizing the health of other voters. COVID-19 patients who are quarantined will be able to cast their vote at the last day of the hours, poll day, at their respective polling stations, as I said earlier, under the supervision of health authorities, strictly following the laid down by us.
All right, Vaidyanathan has been tracking that story and joins us now for more on this. Vaidya, this is to be, in the words of the election commissioner himself, a historic election, the largest that will happen in the world in midst of this pandemic. And lots of interesting changes have been made as well, like there will be online nominations now and no rally that will take place while the nomination is being carried out. Roadshows have been allowed but with restrictions. And then this very interesting bit that the election commissioner has put in about having political parties to upload the criminal backgrounds of candidates that they pick, along with the reason why they have been given a ticket.
See, there are two points. One, as for the cleansing of politics, keeping criminals out of the legislature, that's the Supreme Court judgment. Supreme Court has said that before the polling, three times a candidate will have to make it public what are the cases pending against him. That was repeated by the Election Commission, which has changed its norms. Not only that, court has also said that the political parties on their website, they should upload the criminal cases and also give a reason why, despite all these criminal cases, he has been nominated or put up as a candidate. Mm-hmm. That's what the Chief Election Commission was saying. These are the changes made in the nomination form and the guidelines. Another interesting point is about the social media. You know how the social media, hate speech, everything that has become a controversy now. Mm-hmm. Election Commission would be strictly monitoring the social media platforms and said that they issued a warning saying that if anything happens on the hate speech, Commission will take very strict action.
Right. I also wanted to get some clarity on the door-to-door campaigning, something very key to especially states like Bihar, where in rural areas you expect the candidate to have a reach. Any norms, any specifically the SOPs regarding COVID that have been floated?
See, as far as the localized guidelines are concerned, Bihar state chief electoral officer would be issuing it, but the Election Commission has made it very clear saying that social norms will have to be maintained during the campaign, and even public gathering is also concerned. CEC said that certain grounds have been chosen, with the DM would be knowing it, which can accommodate more people with the social distancing methods. So now the local authorities will have to take care on all these issues.
But there also, when it comes to the positive, COVID positive patients and suspects, that has been a huge conversation online as well. People trying to wonder how exactly will they go to the polling station. Just walk us through what exactly are the guidelines that have been laid out.
The guidelines are, one, they will have to wear masks while coming to voting and also social distancing. But there are some people who may not have a mask, then the polling authorities will hand over the mask to them. Not only that, when you go and vote in the, press the button in the electronic voting machine, at that time the poll officials will hand over the gloves, hand over gloves to the voters. And third point, while you enter the polling booth, your temperature will be checked. If the temperature is high, then you will be asked to wait, come at a later stage at the end of the hour. As for the suspects, as well as positive patients are concerned, they will have to vote at the end of the polling time. Of course, the polling time has been increased from 7 to 6 p.m., but this will not be applicable to Naxal areas.